वेलकम टू अ फ्रेश एपिसोड ऑफ एविएटर टॉक्स। विद अस टुडे इज मिस फ्लाइविंग्स, लीड कैबिन अटेंडेंट, इंडिगो एयरलाइंस। हाय, होप यू आर डूइंग ग्रेट। बिफोर वी बिगिन, कैन वी हैव अ शॉर्ट इंट्रोडक्शन टू आवर व्यूअर्स, सच एज योर नेम, होम टाउन, एयरलाइन सर्विंग एंड डेजिग्नेशन?
Hi guys, how are you guys doing? So you know me as Miss Flymings on YouTube, and I am from City of Joy, Kolkata, which is in West Bengal, and I work for India's leading airline, which is Indigo Airlines, and I'm working as a lead cabin attendant, which is a cabin supervisor, or in other words, cabin in charge. So I have been working for almost 4.5 years now.
How do you define your work? Who is a flight attendant according to you?
The job of flight attendant is not a joke. It is a lot of sacrifice. It is a lot of commitment which is needed by an individual. And it is not only about seeing the world or meeting new people. It is more than that. It is service. It is safety. It is your life at risk. So if I have to define the job of a flight attendant in one word, that would be service from the heart. So my job is to reach out to as many people as I can and help them on board when they are facing any kind of trouble, be it safety related issues or service related issue or any kind of problems that they are facing. So we are there for you on board in case you have any problems, and we are at your rescue all the time.
What kind of service quality is expected from you by your company?
We at our company are expected to be absolutely down to earth and there for people who need us in times of trouble. So for instance, if you have any kind of uncomfortable situation on board with regards to sexually being harassed by anybody on board, or if you are coming across anybody who is drunk and you are uncomfortable with that person, or you know, sitting next to that person makes you feel agitated, or if you are somebody who requires more attention than the rest of the others, coming to like, you know, situations like people having panic attacks, and you know, we as crew are trained in our company to cater to all these situations and to be dealing with all these situations with a very calm and very witty mind, instead of becoming very hyper and judging a situation by the type of person that person is. You know, you could come from different backgrounds, from different status, from a lot of different fields of life, and we as crew are trained in our company to be treating everybody as equal and also giving the equal amount of attention to all the others. We as cabin crew have this motive at the end of the day, that we let everybody go from our flight with a smile, with a positive attitude, and we try our level best to deliver as much as service is expected from us, and also you know, giving them the most comfortable experience that you would have in any airline in the world. There are times where we would have bad days, so our company has trained us in how we can manage these situations and yet have a smile and pleasing personality and deal with situations in that way.
Okay, so what is your most favorite part of the job?
The favorite part of my job comes when I'm done with service and we are done with all our work, and we have to go into the cabin and interact with people. Interaction is something that I feel very important in somebody's life, because the more you interact with people, the more you get to know that person, and there is more close connection with an individual. It could be a family, it could be a couple, it could be children, it could be anybody on your flight, it could be a celebrity, it could be a politician, or anybody who's traveling on your flight. Going and talking to them gives me immense happiness, because that is the only way I can express myself. I'll tell you an incident. When I came across a couple and I was talking to them, and how I could express my feelings and my desires to them as well, as to what I would want to do in future with my life, and what I would want to do out of my investments and savings, and a lot of plans that I could also share with these people who are actually strangers but become family to you in just a couple of hours. So this is the best part of the job, which is the interaction round that we have with people. It is something that you need to do from your heart, and I feel that this is something that, you know, helps you to ease out some of the tension that you are going through in your daily life with regards to your family, your friends, or peer pressure, or whatever kind of stress you are going through. It's the best way to ease out that and to, you know, be free and to consider them as your family. So that is the favorite part of my job, which is interaction.
How was your first flying experience as an attendant?
So my first day in the airline was a very, very memorable day for me, because I remember being dragged like really bad by one of my colleagues. So I was absolutely a newbie to this job, and I was 19 years old. So they got a very good opportunity to, you know, make fun of me and, you know, just have it and show me how difficult life at aviation is too. But I remember this lead cabin attendant of mine, she came to me and she told me that, you know, the captain is calling you in the cockpit and he wants to know your knowledge about how much you've been trained. So I went into the cockpit and he asked me to take out the QDN. Now the QDN is actually a quick donning mask, which is used in situations of decompression or maybe smoke in the cabin or any kind of emergency situation. It is like a breathing equipment. So he asked me to take it out and don it on myself and regulate it and reuse it. So it was really embarrassing for me, because although I knew how to do it, I was a little bit shy and I didn't know him. So it was first time coming in contact with a stranger and, you know, talking to somebody you know, so freely. It was a difficult task for me, so naturally I did it. And when I wore that mask, he quickly took out his phone and he took a picture of me. So I was really embarrassed and I was like, you know, dragged, and I was like almost into tears, because I thought what this man is gonna do with that particular picture. But at the end of the flight, it was a very, very amazing day for me, because my crew, they cut a small cake for me, and the captain offered me chocolates to, you know, like pacify me and, you know, just like, you know, make the situation cool, a little cooler, a little calm, because it was my first day at work and he didn't want me to, you know, pressurize me too much so that it affects my work. So he, you know, just gave me some sweets, and my crew, they all cheered me up and they were like, you know, we just played the fool with you and we just wanted to see your reaction. But this is not how it goes. It's just that, you know, we just wanted to play the fool with you and just have a little fun, and we wanted to see your take to this kind of situation. So these are situations that you come across even on flight. What would you do in these situations? You can't start crying, or, you know, become very emotional. So this was the first day on flight, and it was one experience that I can never forget. It was one, like, you know, if I have to say, it was like the most memorable day of my life. One of the most memorable days of my life, definitely.
What is your timetable on a busy day?
So my timetable is very variable. It's not fixed. So depending on my timetable, it is, you know, different things are done at different times. Naturally, I do not have a particular time when I wake up, or a particular time where I have to, you know, have breakfast or lunch or dinner. Everything is like, you know, everything is like very haphazard, and you have to just go with the flow. So on a regular day, I would just, you know, wake up. If I have a morning flight, I would just wake up, have a glass of lime water, and then I would just, you know, grab a bite and then get ready, go for work. And the entire day goes at work. So when I come back, I just, you know, prepare something for myself very quickly, maybe a bowl of oats or any cereal, and then I would just grab a bite of that. And since it's very tiring for me after flight to, you know, do anything at all, so all I need is the bed, and I just go to sleep for the longest time. The first time I came after flight, I was so tired. I slept for like 15 hours straight because I felt the pressure, the type of work that you have to do as a cabin attendant is not easy. It's very strenuous and it is a lot of pressurizing. So you have to cope up with it with time, and that's how a normal day at work goes.
What safety drills did you undergo while training? What are your refresher training protocols?
So some of the drills that we undergo as cabin attendants are ditching drills, which is like jumping into a pool of water and you know, surviving passengers, surviving yourselves. So few of us become survivors and few of us become flight attendants, and we survive each other. We have to board the raft and help each other how to survive in a situation where aircraft ditches into water. That is one drill that you have. The other drill is a slide drill, in which you have to slide down the aircraft in case you have a crash landing and you have to vacate the aircraft as it is possible. Then the other training that we have is a fire drill, in case there's smoke in the cabin or fire in the cabin or any kind of fumes that you see because of lithium batteries or maybe because of sudden burning of matchsticks, which is not actually allowed. But some people, you know, they are really smart, so they just sneak in and there may be a cause of fire. So how to fight those fire in times of an emergency? So a firefighting drill is taught to us. And apart from that, a lot of safety procedures, like how to evacuate the aircraft, what are the commands that we are supposed to shout in unison, and a lot of emergency training is taught. Theory training is conducted once every year, so once in 12 months we have to go back and we have to refresh our training, because it is mandatory to be refreshing these trainings as we have a license that we have to abide by, and if the license expires you cannot fly. So we have to go every year back to the training center and get trained. Refreshing training is being done for everyone, so we go back and go through this training again. And with regards to drills, we go for the drills once in 3 years. So drills are something that is very important, and to refresh that you have to go to the training center, which is a simulator where we have our drills. We have to go back once every 3 years and get these drills done.
What early preparations you suggest for aspiring flight attendants?
So to all the youngsters watching this video, I will give you a piece of advice which I think is very beneficial for all of you, which is practicing your communication skills, because a lot depends on how you speak, and practicing the way you sit, the way you eat, the way you talk to a person, the tone of speech, how fast you are speaking, how slow you are speaking, and you know, coming to a certain position where you can express yourself, and you know, using the correct terms, how to speak correctly is very important. Holding good knowledge about how you can communicate with somebody and being situationally aware is something that I would like to tell you to work upon from now onwards. If you are in class 8, 9, 10 and even 11, 12, it's never too late to prepare yourself for anything. All you need to give is at least a year or so to train yourself in a particular thing, because a year is a lot for somebody to brush up themselves. Some of the qualities that you know you could adopt to become a cabin attendant would be having a lot of patience. You need to be very patient, and you know, you have to keep yourself calm at all points in time. You cannot get irritated. You have to practice to be smiling all the time, no matter how much you are agitated or irritated with somebody in life. Or you know, you cannot let your personal problems mix with your professional life. So you have to keep them separate. That's what I do. I always keep my professional and personal life separate from each other. There is no mixing of people. There is no mixing of colleagues in my personal life. I always keep them separate. I draw a line between both, and I know my limits. So practicing how you can have self-control is very important if you want to become a cabin crew in future. And it is very easy to, you know, have patience for some time, but in the long run, when you are coming across a customer who is very angry and he's shouting at you, he's abusing you, he's calling you names, and he's using language, you lose your patience, which is very important to have. So I feel that patience is something that you have to have as a cabin crew. And you know, having a pleasant smile all the time is something that you can work upon in general as well, because when you have a pleasant smile, a smile can solve all the problems of your life. If a person is depressed, if a person is sad, and if you motivate him with a smile and you know, have a pleasing, calm tone, you can always make that person's day. So that is what I feel. I feel that these are some tips and guidance and advice that you know would help you and help you to reach your goal in future. If you dream, if you are an aspirant, and if you love flying, if you wish to be a cabin crew someday flying in the sky, and I wish you all luck if you are going for the interview, if you are preparing yourself, all the very best. So that's the piece of advice that I would like to give you, and thank you so much for having me.
Thank you very much for joining us, Ms. Flywinch. Thank you for sharing your experience. This will definitely help our viewers. Thank you so much.